Hey there, do-it-yourself technicians. We all love LEDs, and LEDs with a sensor must be even better, right? In this, part two of odd, fun, weird, and occasionally useful things that I've bought online, we're going to look at this mini LED with sensor that I bought on Wish. I bought them to light up a couple of different places that I thought they might be useful. One of them is this cupboard where my coffee maker lives. The shape of the cupboard means that even with the lights on, it's just a little bit dark once you stand right in front of the coffee maker to make the coffee. This little light works perfectly, shedding just enough light to be able to see without getting in the way at all. It's been in there for a month and is showing no sign whatsoever of needing recharging. And even when it does, it'll just be a case of pulling it off, plugging it into the charger for a few hours, and then putting it back. The second place I wanted to use it is our ensuite, where I hoped it might shed enough light to do what needs to be done without the blinding overhead light that has a habit of waking you up more than is really necessary. I'm still playing with different locations for this one, as you don't want it somewhere where the LEDs are shining directly at you, but it still needs to shed enough light and be able to sense you. Each light ships with its own little charging cable and a small metal plate and piece of double-sided tape. Mounted in the bottom of the light itself is a small magnet. The idea being, you stick the metal plate wherever you need it to go, and then just magnet the light onto it, which makes it really easy to remove for recharging. At the moment, I've actually just blue-tacked the one in above the coffee machine, because I wasn't sure it was exactly the right place. Now that I know I'm happy with the location, as soon as I pull it down for recharging, I'll stick the plate up. There's a couple of things I don't like about these, and the first is the timing. The light only stays on for 25 seconds. That's fine if you're still moving around underneath it, because it just stays on. But if you're sitting really still, I find it goes off just a little bit too quickly. It would be really cool if there was some sort of setting, even just jumper pins inside, that would allow you to extend the length that the light stays on. But, of course, that's going to increase the price of manufacture. I did take it apart to check if that was an option, and because I like taking things apart. Looking inside, I noticed that the battery is just a standard rechargeable AA battery, which is great because it's an off-the-shelf part and means it's cheaper to make. The second thing I noticed was that there are six LEDs inside, seven if you include the red LED to indicate charging. When I went back and looked at the ad, I noticed that there are three different options: a 7 LED version with no sensor, a 12 LED version with sensor, which is this one, supposedly, and a much larger 30cm one with 20 LEDs and a sensor. I went back and double-checked my order, and I definitely paid for the 12 LED version with sensor, so I'm definitely going to query that with Wish. To be honest though, I'm not too concerned. 12 LEDs would probably be way too bright, especially for the ensuite. But it's the principle of getting what you paid for. Speaking of paid, I paid $26 for a 4-pack with $14 shipping to Australia. So I got 4 for $40 or $10 each. It's not too bad and they really are quite useful. So I'm not at all unhappy. If you're interested in this or something similar, see the link up above or down in the comments below. And use my code KKCMDXT. For up to $8 off your first Wish order. Question of the day: do you have a dark spot in your place that could do with some extra light? Let me know in the comments down below, and if this video was useful to you, give it a thumbs up. Thank you. The Tech Doctor exists to help you become your own technician. Learn about the technology, protect yourself from the bad guys, and fix it when it breaks. There's some older videos you may not have seen before, here and here. And you can subscribe to our channel by clicking down here, or to our mailing list by clicking up here. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day, and I'll see you on the next episode. Bye.